السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
نعم، name, state and question please.
Yes, my name is Iman. I'm calling from Pennsylvania.
Your question, Sister Iman, go ahead please. Sister Iman, here is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us regarding this issue. Before you go to sleep, make sure that you recite Ayatul Kursi. Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyu al-qayyum la ta'khudhuhu sinatun wa la nawm. And then make that beautiful dua, Bismika Allahumma amutu wa ahya. And of course there is another beautiful dua, Allahumma wajjahtu wajhi ilayk wa dhahri ilayk la malja wa la manja minka illa ilayk. And if you don't memorize it, just say Bismika Allahumma, in your name, oh Allah, I am to live and I am to die. Because you're about to go into a state of minor death basically. Allah told us that when we sleep, we go into a state of minor death. Allahu yatawaffa al-anfusa hina mawtiha. As soon as you wake up from your sleep, remember Allah. Say, Alhamdulillah, alladhi ahyana ba'da ma amatana wa ilayhi an-nushur. Alhamdulillah, alladhi ahyana ba'da ma amatana wa ilayhi an-nushur. All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who given us life after we were dead, and to Him is the final return. Now I said do not use an alarm clock which has music on it, because as soon as you hear the music, I'm telling you, you're not going to remember this dua that you should make. Alhamdulillah, alladhi ahyana ba'da ma amatana wa ilayhi an-nushur. Now you have got rid of one knot. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us when we sleep, shaitan ties three knots on our necks. And he would tell us, sleep, you have a long night, a long day tomorrow. And the first knot that you remember, that you wake up from your sleep, and the first thing which you do, you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by making this dua. Second, you leave the bed as fast as possible, as quick as possible, and make wudu. But be careful now, because you go and sit in the bathroom and then, you know, you start thinking and shaitan would start actually to take you back to bed. No, very quickly make wudu. If you make wudu, you have gotten rid of the second knot. Then when you pray, the third knot is done. Then you're free. Shaitan has no power over you. You're good to go. You have won. So remember, shaitan ties three knots on your neck before you go to sleep. The first knot, you relieve it, you take care of it by remembering Allah. The second knot by making wudu, the third knot by standing and praying. Then you're good to go.
How do you make sure that you wake up for Fajr without fail every morning?
Make sure that you have the intention that you want to wake up. And Allah knows best if you have the intention or not. Wallahi, Sister Iman, if you have the determined intention that you want to wake up, the angel will wake you up, inshallah. You will see that you wake up. This is number one. Number two, seek the means. You know, the intention always have to be always assured by seeking some physical means. Alarm clock. We have alarm clocks now in our phones, in our watches. Use an alarm clock to basically wake you up. But make sure that you don't use one of those which wakes you up with music. This is the worst thing.